Hey everyone! In this video, I am going to show you how you can grade discussions in Canvas. So if you've been following my videos, I have a large series of Canvas LMS tutorials for online teachers. If you haven't checked that playlist out, I will link it in the cards down below. And if this is our first time meeting, hi, I'm Ashlee Espinosa. I have an MFA in musical theater and I am an online teacher, an actor, and a musical theater coach. So I hope this video helps you. It's part of my Canvas tutorials playlist. If you want more tutorials, check it out in the playlist below. Otherwise, let's get started and talk about discussions, how you can grade them, and some tips and tricks along the way that I've got for you. All right, let's dive in. So the first thing you want to do is go to the discussions tab on the left-hand side or however you navigate best to the discussion sections. And then you can see this is an old class again a couple years ago or so, just as to use as an example. Now you can see that I've got my discussions. I've got one pinned because I like to do a discussion board for the students or a student lounge that I manage, but they usually use. And then you can see this one actually wasn't used quite a lot, but some students find it helpful depending on the class and the subject matter and the topic and the age of the students. So if we go into these discussions, I do have them all set up, but let's go into one. Say you go through it this route. Go to the top right-hand corner and click on the hamburger. And you want to go down to Speedgrader. This is one way to go to discussions, but you can also navigate that by going to the grades on the left-hand side. And you'll notice that I do have my students' information covered up for their privacy. But you can also go to the discussions tab in the gradebook here. Say these are the ones that have been submitted. Click on the hamburger on the far right-hand corner of that column. And then you can go to Speedgrader. Either way really works. It's just whatever is the easiest and the quickest for you. Now, when you open the discussion in Speedgrader here, this is how you grade the students' discussion posts. It's really, really easy, and I'm gonna show you a couple other tips. The first thing is you're going to see in the top right-hand corner all of the students' names. Now again, my students' names are covered up for their privacy, but you can click the arrow right over here on the right side. It will drop down and list their names in alphabetical order by last name, which I find really helpful. If there's a green check mark on the left side of their name, that means that you have graded it. And then if you haven't, I think it says it's something different. There's no check mark or it's in a circle or whatnot. And of course, all these are graded because they are a previous class. So you can navigate through the students that way. If you'd like to not go in order, you can click on their name and it will open up their discussions. But it does start from the beginning of the alphabet and goes through your roster that way. Now, the top right-hand corner is going to give you the arrow to go to the next student. So you can just click it and it will shuffle through them in that same order. So let's take a look. For example, here's one student's name. Again, the bulk of this information and their name are covered for their privacy. But what I like to do is on the left-hand side, you can use this bar to make one side bigger or smaller. You'll see some students might have a larger discussion, some of them might be shorter. So you can navigate this to work for the way that it feels better to your eyes. I like to make the left-hand side a lot bigger because I can read their discussions. Now, notice that this student has two discussions for this one, two posts on the discussion for this one post. And the reason why is because I required them to post an initial comment or initial thread, and then they also had to comment on at least one other student's post. So you're going to see everything that this one student, the page that you're on for their grading, every single thread. Now let me see if I just scroll through here. I'll show you a couple more examples. Notice this student, this was their initial post, the first one. After they post their initial post, it then unlocks all of the threads. So I have it set up in my discussion where they have to post their initial comment and then they can see everybody else's posts in that thread to then make their required comments. So this one, that was hit their first post. And then you can see this student actually commented on a few other students' threads. So you're seeing everything that they did in one place, which is fabulous. Now, what I like to do is on the left-hand side over here, I like to create a rubric. When I want to use the rubric, I just slide out that toolbar again, make it a little bit bigger. And then I have two rubrics here. So this assignment, this one discussion is worth 10 points total. You'll see down here, I had this rubric set up. And then I have clarity of discussion post. And then that means, did the student support their answer with the correct information as provided in the lectures? And then I have grammar and punctuation. Okay, so did the student answer the discussion in complete sentences free of grammatical errors? You can set this up however you'd want to, but I really suggest some type of rubric. And all you do is set that rubric up when you're creating the discussion post. And I have a video about that. I'll link it down in the cards for you below, how to do that to start off with. But what this does is when you go to grade, now I can type here in the comments, I can type something to them regarding this part of the rubric. I can put the points in here, 1 or 2 or 3 or 0, and then I can tell them why when I'm grading, why they got a 0. You know, they didn't meet the minimum requirements of 4 sentences or words or whatever you'd like to include in there. And then after you put these in here, say it's 5, and then say it's 5, and you say maybe great job or full points or whatnot, you can then click save and it will automatically total this point in your gradebook for them. So you don't have to do anything else. One place, staying in one place is fabulous. Something else you can do is actually save. If you want to type in here, you know, great job, I enjoyed reading this post or whatever you'd like, you can click save this comment for reusing it. And it kind of keeps a little template of comments that you can pop in there and then just update or add their name in it. It's a great way to give the students more feedback in the discussion post versus just points. Rubrics totally up to you. And then when you click save, and that will save it to the student's grade. Now, also while you're grading it here, whether you have a rubric set up or not, you put the points in this little box here. Now it can be percentage or points depending on, again, how you set this up in the initial discussion post breakdown. In this box down here, you can put comments. I highly suggest using the comments, especially for online learning. Type something in here that says their name and then gives them feedback as to what you really liked about it, what they could have done that maybe was better, reminders to write in full sentences, or reminders to be include your opinion and support your opinion with citations or however you would like to set it up. You have a few other options down here as well, though. If you're tired of typing, which sometimes I do get really tired of comments, it takes me longer to type it out. Not only can you type in comments, but now you can do speech recognition by clicking on this button on the right side under the text box that looks like a megaphone. Click it and you can speak and it will type it for you. For example, click the red button when you're ready to record. Hi, Sally. I think this discussion post was really exceptional. I'm exceptionally proud of you, and I can't wait to see what your next discussion is. And then it will pop that up in the box on the right, saving you time. And you may just need to edit a few things, but it's really helpful as well. Okay, so you can do that. You can also upload a video by clicking this link in the middle. Click that button and you can record something for them. So let's say, for example, I have a couple other cameras hooked up to this, but let's say, for example, you want to record with your mic and you want to record a voice memo for them. Click on the left side that says mic, select which microphone you would like to use, and then you can start recording. Click start recording. It's going to count down. And then you just record what you would like to, and when you're done recording that memo, click finish. It's going to pop that in here, and you can play it back. And then you just record what you would like to, and when you're done recording that memo, click finish. And then all you have to do is you can give it a title down here, and then click save. And it will pop it into the comment section for them. Now, same thing, go back to that icon, and you can also click upload media. So you can upload a file you've already recorded, or you can upload a video file that you've already recorded as well. Now, let's say you want to, in the moment, record from your webcam. Go back to the record media section, click the right-hand button that says webcam, pick the webcam you'd like to record from, and then literally, you can record a video for your students. I actually use this all the time because it's really helpful and it's quick and fast, and they get to visually see me as well. So that's another great option to give them feedback about their discussion. You just click, again, start recording. It will count you down. After it counts you down, then you record your video. Hi, good job, so proud of you. Click finish, test it out.
Down, then you record your video. Hi, good job, so proud of you. Click down.
And then you put a title in there, and then you click save. And it is then going to pop that up into, again, your comments box. So you have those options as well. After you're done with all of those comments, anything you're gonna upload, then all you have to do is click submit at the bottom and it will submit all of that information to the student. Then you can either click go to the next one by clicking the top arrow in the right-hand corner, or you can click then on the names and choose it from the slide down menu. And then after you're done grading all of those discussions, you can go straight back into the grade book, and then all of your grades will be there for you. If this video was helpful for you, please click the like, the thumbs up button below. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you want to see new videos about teaching online or Canvas tutorials. I've got new ones coming out every single week for you. Happy teaching, everyone, and thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.